The Battle of Gallipoli is a huge cultural touchstone for Australians and New Zealanders. It's the first time that they've engaged in warfare under their own flag. Prior to that, they were an extension of the British Empire. Right, right. They fought in the Crimea, they fought in the Boer War, you know. But now they are under their own flag, and it's a group of volunteers. You know, it's an expeditionary force of volunteers. Britain puts out the call, says, you know, we need help in our defence and the defence of our European friends. And they ask for volunteers, and hundreds of thousands of men in Australia and New Zealand put up their hands. It's a story about a man who has three children who go to war and don't come back. You know, I'm a dad of two boys, so that's going to get me at a very essential level. But this other thing was there too, and this may actually be the most important thing. It felt to me that there was an opportunity to make a war film or a film that talks about war with a level of honesty that other people haven't really taken it to, you know? I mean, I know that there's sort of a cliche that, you know, some people say that every war film is an anti-war film, but that's not true, because we quite often couch these actions in terms of bravery and courage, and we leave it at that. We don't talk about grief. We don't talk about that moment between engagements when the wounded men are lying in the field calling for water, calling for their mothers, calling for God. Yeah. You know, we don't see it in that way. So it comes with a huge responsibility, a movie like this. A responsibility to a contemporary audience to not speak down to them, to actually take them to a place where, you know, the geopolitics and the history of the time, they're not necessarily completely on top of, you know, or they don't really know anything about, you know. It has a responsibility to the men and women who are actually in service for our countries, mm-hmm. and what they're really facing.